screen?
Yes, uncle.
Oh, great. So let's get started with our session number 17. Okay, episode 17 of Fun with Heroes. Okay, we are resuming after the break of 2 weeks. Right. So now this week we are going to talk about four heroes. Okay. I'm picking out two from the month of January that we didn't cover, and two from this week only, okay. Last week of February. So who are these four people? Anyone has any idea about these four people? These are the people we are going to cover. Any name? Any name you know? No, that's fine. That's fine. So we have diverse set of people. Okay, few of them are actually freedom fighters who fought against the British.
One looks like a lawyer.
One is a lawyer, judge. He's a judge. He did amazing things. And we have a different set of people. There is a one from Gujarat. There is a one from Manipur. Okay, extreme ends of India, right?
East Manipur is the first one. The first row, left, right one.
Okay, that's okay. Right one. And then we also have someone from present Bangladesh. Okay, Chittagong. And then there is someone who did amazing work outside India. He was an Indian, but he did something extraordinary outside India. So let's see who are these people and what are those stories, interesting stories we have. So the very first story we have is Rani Gaibindlu.
Manipur, I told you.
Yeah, and she is also known as Rani Ma by the people of Manipur. So the Rani Ma was born on 26 January 1915 in Nungkaw village of Manipur, also known as the Longkaw village of Manipur. So she was born on the same day as the Republic Day, right? 26 January. And yeah. She belonged to the Rongmei tribe of Manipur. These are tribal people of Manipur, and she belonged to the tribe. And her family was actually a ruling clan.
Necklace.
Yeah, tribal necklace, and that's why she was called the Rani. Okay, Rani Ma, because they belong to the ruling clan of that village. Now, at the very young age of 13, she got associated with the Heraka movement. That was headed by her cousin, with Haipu Chedonang, who was her cousin and the leader of the Heraka movement. Oh, what was the Heraka movement? The Heraka movement was a religious movement against the British that time. The aim was to unite the Naga tribes against the British invaders. Okay, so that movement was started by her cousin Haipu Jadonan. Okay, and they were trying to unite the Naga people against the British. Okay, so and that was gaining momentum. So British was afraid of that. So in 1931, Jadonan was captured by the British and he was killed. Okay. British killed him. So after that, Rani Gaibindlu became the leader of Heraka movement. And when she became the leader of Heraka movement in 1932, she was only 16. Okay. She was very young. At the age of 16, she became the leader of that movement. And she openly rebelled against the British and started different movements. There was one movement called No Tax Movement, where they stopped paying taxes to the British authorities, and then created a small army and started attacking the British. So this is something that was happening in the northeast part of India. These stories are generally not known. Actually, we know a lot about the non-cooperation movement or the revolutionary movements of Bhagat Singh and other people, but this is also something happening in the northeast, especially in the lands of Nagaland and Manipur. This was happening at that time. So now British saw her as a threat. And they even had a bounty for her to capture her. They made several attempts. Then in 1932, she was captured from a Pulomi village and was sentenced to imprisonment in jail. So she was sent to jail. And she remained in prison for 15 years till India became independent. In 1947, when India became independent, she was finally released from the jail. And she continued fighting even after independence. She continued fighting for the people of her region. Okay, and she worked for with the people through peaceful and democratic and non-violent means. So she remained active activist for the rest of her life. And in 1982, she was conferred with the Padma Bhushan. So that's the story of Rani Gaidelu. Amazing story of from the northeast of India.
Activism, what kind of activism?
She was doing a lot of things, right? She was basically uniting the her tribes and the formation of a separate jilla.
Against who? Like activism after independence, so against who?
Against the local authorities, basically, because there were some local demands that were not met. So she was uniting those people, and she but in a peaceful manner, okay, and got those approved. Okay. So that's the story of Rani Gaidelu. Next story we have is of a judge, and judge is Radha Binod Pal. Now Radha Binod Pal was born on 27 January 1886 in a small village of Salimpur of Bengal Presidency. He was a Bengali, and at a very young age, he lost his father. See, he formally didn't go to a school that time, but he was grazing the cows. While grazing a cow, he would listen to the lectures in a local primary school from outside. So there is a story associated. He was not enrolled in a school, but he would listen to the lectures from the outside, okay, while grazing his cows. So one day, some school inspector visited that school. Okay, and he asked some questions, but none of the students in the class could answer that thing. But this Radha Binod Pal answered that. Okay, so the inspector was.
How could he answer if he wasn't allowed inside the school?
He was listening to the school lectures from outside, from the window. Okay, so he was gaining knowledge from there. So when the inspector asked a few questions in the class, so he's then when none of the students could answer that question, he shouted from outside that I know the answer. Then inspector allowed him. Okay, can you tell the answer? Then he actually correctly answered all the questions. So the school inspector was very impressed with this. So he then admitted Pal in the school and gave him a monetary stipend. He was not attending school because he was very poor that time. So they gave him some stipend and he started attending school. And he was a very bright student, so he ultimately became a lawyer and judge. Okay, he did a law study from the University of Calcutta, and ultimately he got enrolled in. He worked with the Indian the government that time, and even was a contributor to the Income Tax Act of 1922. He was one of the contributors in formation of that act. He was also working as a legal advisor of the government. Now the greatest feat or greatest achievement of his life came after World War II. So after the World War II, was fought between two different groups of countries, right? Allies countries and there's Axis country. Axis country was basically German, Japanese, and others, okay, Italy and others, and Allies countries were the British, America, and others. Now. Of course, the Allies country won that war. Okay, so after the victory, they started a trial of captured Japanese criminals. Okay, they called them war criminals in Japan, in Tokyo. The trial was known as a Tokyo trial. Okay. And that included even the Japan's then Prime Minister, Tojo. Okay. So they were doing a legal trial against those people for war crimes. Okay, this came to known as a Tokyo trial. Now, different countries sent their judges for the trial. Okay, so America sent a judge, British sent a judge, and there was a judge was sent from India, who was Radha Binod Pal. So Radha Binod Pal represented India that time.
Uncle, could you explain this this man again, because I couldn't hear you because of the loud music.
Okay, sure. So after the World War II, the British won. Okay, so they started a trial against the captured Japanese top officials, including the Prime Minister of Japan, okay, and again for the war crime they did, the crime they did during the war. So they started the trial, formal trials, and the trials are called the Tokyo trials in the history. Now the different countries sent their judges. Okay, this was an international trial. There are multiple countries were part of this. So from India, Radha Vinod Pal was sent to represent India. Okay. So Justice Pal was nominated by the British Indian government to represent British India that time in the Tokyo trial. And the trial, so there were 12 judges total. So rest 11 judges from across the world found that Japan is guilty of war crimes. Okay. But Pal was the sole dissenting judge. Okay. He didn't agree with the rest of the judges. And he gave a judgment that was like 1,235 pages long judgment. The important part about the judgment that he signified that very importantly, that during the World War II, Allies country, the countries that who won actually, America and British, they also violated a lot of international laws. Okay. And especially the nuclear bomb. Okay, nuclear bomb that was dropped on Japan, that killed millions of people. That was also a violation of international laws, right? Because most of the people who died in the nuclear, they were innocent people.
They like Tsar bomb.
Yes. So he made that argument. And he, even though ultimately the Japanese were found to be guilty because the majority was in favor of that, but he managed to reduce the sentences of a lot of Japanese officials, and he managed to avoid capital punishment, that is a hanging or a death for some of them. So because of this, he was appreciated by Japan a lot. Okay, even till today, he's very much a respected figure in Japan. And after this trial, he was elected to United Nations, the UN, it's an international law commission. And in 1950, can you go on more, Samal? Yeah, okay. And he was awarded, in 1959, he was awarded Padma Vibhushan by Indian government. Okay. And the Emperor of Japan also gave him their highest civilian honor. Japan's highest civilian honor was also conferred to Radha Vinod Pal because of the service he did to Japanese.
What is Japan's highest honor?
I forgot the name actually. I'll get back to it. Because at that time it was a different one. Right now it is known as different. Just recently, I think last year it was given to Narendra Modi as well. Yeah, so that was Japan's highest honor. I think Order of Merit. Order of
no, Merit. When Radha Vinod Pal was there, what was it like that I'm asking? Not now.
Yeah, I'll try to get the answer, Japan. I have mentioned somewhere. Well, yeah, I'll note that down. Yeah. So that's the story of Radha Vinod Pal. Even today, there is a statue of Radha Vinod Pal in front of Japan's Supreme Court. Okay. Yeah. So Supreme.
That's how famous he is.
Yeah, that's
lots famous. Of people were saved from getting hanged by Radha Vinod Pal.
Yes, the Japanese. Okay, so the Supreme Order of Chrysanthemum, that's the name. The Supreme Order of the Chrysanthemum is the name of the Japanese. There is a different name in Japanese, which is the Grand Cordon, is kind of it is called. That's the name it has. So that's the story of Radha Vinod Pal. Now, let's move to Jatinder Mohan Sengupta. So I don't know if you remember, but earlier we had a story of Neeli Sengupta. In January.
Yes.
Okay.
So is his brother something?
No. He Jatinder Mohan Sengupta is her husband. Okay. Okay. So we have stories of both wife and husband. So Jatinder Mohan Sengupta was born on 22nd February in 1885 at Chittagong, which is in Bangladesh right now.
Chittagong, that's where Surya Sen was also there.
Yes, yes, yes. Chittagong was a very hotbed of political activities and revolutionary activities that time. So Jatinder studied the Presidency College of Calcutta, and then he went to England to study law. And he also became a lawyer, very successful lawyer. He came back to India. He married Neeli Sengupta actually. They came back to India and established a very successful law practice. And then he was inspired by the non-cooperation movement of Gandhiji and joined the Indian National Congress. So he was leading that non-cooperation movement in Chittagong, in this part of India. Okay. He took an active part in freedom struggle, and he gave up his legal practice, okay, which was a very lucrative legal practice that time. He gave up that. He organized a strike of a Mumbai oil company in 1923. Okay. And then he was elected as the to the Bengal Legislative Council, which was the administrative unit of the Bengal. He was elected in the elections there. He then left Congress and moved to the Swaraj Party. Swaraj Party was a party of the Chittaranjan Das. Okay, Chittaranjan Das was a mentor of Subhash Chandra Bose. So Jatinder Mohan also worked with Chittaranjan Das. And after Chittaranjan Das, Jatinder Mohan Sen Gupta became the president of Bengal Swaraj Party. He also became the mayor of Kolkata. Okay. And he was arrested multiple times. In 1930, he was arrested from Rangoon. He was at that time he was opposing the British India for the Bengal partition in Rangoon. So he was arrested there. As a lawyer, Jatinder Mohan Sen Gupta actually fought the cases of the Chittagong uprising. So after the Chittagong uprising, okay, that was done by Sujaya Sen.
Yes, and lots of other people, right?
A lot of people actually, they were participating in that, right? So they were arrested, okay? So they, again, their legal trial, when they started, so Jatinder Mohan Sen Gupta was one of the lawyers who fought for those revolutionaries, okay? Their cases he fought. And he in 1931, he also went to England and participated in the Round Table Conference. The Round Table Conference was between the Indian leaders and the British viceroy, okay? So he participated in those conferences, and he actually showcased to the world the British police atrocities in Chittagong. So at that time, what used to happen that outside India, no one would know what is going on, I mean, how the British were torturing the Indians and what was wrong here. So no one was portraying that to the world. So Jatinder Mohan Sen Gupta did that. He went to England and showcased to the world media that what was going on in Chittagong. Yeah. And he was again, after this, he was arrested and he was detained in Pune, then ultimately shifted to Ranchi. Unfortunately, he died in prison only. His health deteriorated, and in prison, he died at the age of 48. In 1933, he died. But his wife, as we discussed earlier, Nelly Sen Gupta, continued his struggle even after his death. Okay. And in Bengal, Jatinder Mohan Sen Gupta was a very popular leader at that time, and he was called
Deshpriya.
He was called Deshpriya. Deshpriya means basically is an honorable name in Bengali. Okay, he was like a loved by country. Deshpriya. Okay, so Desh means country, Priya means love.
Love.
All right. So he was loved by the people of his country. So that title was given to him, Deshpriya, the Bengali title. Okay. So that's the story of Jatinder Mohan Sen Gupta. Next, we move to Morarji Desai. Okay. And
your surname, uncle.
Yes, and Morarji Desai, what's so unique about him? So he's one of the leaders whose birthday is on 29th February. Okay, so this doesn't come every year, right? This comes only in leap year. So he's one of very few people born on 29th February. Okay, famous people.
Yeah. My cousin's also born on that day.
Yeah. So he's the only prime minister to have this birthday right now. Right. So 29th February. So he was born in the Bareilly village near Valsad on 29th February 1896. So we saw the story from Northeast, from Chittagong, and now we are moving to Gujarat. So he was the leader from Gujarat. And after graduation, he joined civil services and worked as a deputy collector. So he was doing the government service. But then he resigned from the government job and joined the Mahatma Gandhi's civil disobedience movement in 1930, at the time of Gandhi March. He joined Congress, he became disciple of Gandhiji, and actively participated in the freedom struggle. And he was jailed for multiple times. So he did a lot of work during the freedom struggle, but his major part came after independence. So after independence, by the time of independence, he became one of the important leaders of Congress. So he became Minister of Home and Revenue in Bombay State. At the time of independence, there was a unified Bombay State, right, which was including the present-day Gujarat and Maharashtra. Okay, he was a minister of home and revenue in that state. He also became the chief minister of Bombay state later on in 1952. And one of the important thing he did at that time, okay, he was closely associated with Sardar Patel. Okay, Sardar Patel, he was like a disciple of Sardar Patel and worked very closely with him. So he played a very important role in the establishment of Amul, the cooperative milk movement. Okay.
Yeah.
Desai, yeah. So he actually helped establishment of Amul. Okay. And then he became the chief minister of Bombay State, as I mentioned. And then he was moved to Delhi from Bombay state. He was moved to Delhi under Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru, and he became a Minister of Commerce and Industry, and then ultimately became the Finance Minister under Jawaharlal Nehru. And Morarji Desai became served as the Finance Minister under Indira Gandhi as well. Okay, and he is till date, he is the longest serving Finance Minister. He presented 10 budgets. A budget is a financial statement every year we have in month of February, right?
Sitaraman is preparing for it.
Yeah, right now the Finance Minister is Nirmala Sitaraman. Yes, so Morarji Desai is still the longest serving Finance Minister. He presented 10 budgets, okay, under Jawaharlal Nehru and then under Indira Gandhi. Okay, he was also Deputy Prime Minister to Indira Gandhi between 1967 to 69, and he is also the only Finance Minister to present budget on his own birthday. Okay, so earlier the budget used to be at the end of February. So in the 1964 and 1968, he presented budgets on 29 February. So he is the only Finance Minister to present budget on his own birthday. Okay.
He must have put cakes on it.
Yeah. And then in the 1970, he left Congress and he led protest against the Indira Gandhi government. Okay. There was a lot of there was a protest going on in Gujarat. There was a protest going on in Bihar. He was also
arrested. When was this?
In 1970s. Around 1975, okay, there was an emergency. You might be saying okay, there was a.
Yeah, you were told that somebody else was jailed.
Yeah, a lot of people. Yeah, a lot of people were jailed, right? Jai Prakash Narayan, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, and other people. So Morarji Desai was also one of the leading. At that time, actually, Morarji Desai was a very senior leader and was a direct competitor to Indira Gandhi. So he was also jailed at that time. And after emergency in 1977, when the Janata Party formed the government, Morarji Desai became the first non-Congress Prime Minister of India. Okay, at the age of 81, so he till date he is the oldest person to become Prime Minister. Okay, at the age of 81.
When did he become Prime Minister?
In 1977. Okay. In 1977, he became the Prime Minister, for 2 years he was the Prime Minister.
Then he was 81.
Yes, he was 81. Okay, his government made a lot of changes in the constitution to make it impossible to impose the emergency again. So that is one of the important things he did that time. After 2 years, he retired and then ultimately retired from the politics. He was very old that time anyway. One of the key highlight of his professional the political life is he was given Bharat Ratna later on, and then he was also given Nishane Pakistan by Pakistan, which is the highest honor of Pakistan. So he is the only Indian to receive the highest honor of both India and Pakistan. Okay.
Nishani Pakistan.
Yes, Nishani Pakistan is similar to Bharat Ratna of India. Okay, and he. And Morarji Desai is the only Indian to receive both of them. Okay, no other person has received that. Okay, both these awards. So.
Can you go a little bit slow?
Yes,
I'm not clear your words.
Okay. Tell me, what should I repeat? Okay, we have time.
It is okay, but a little bit slow.
Okay, no issue. Anyway, this is the last story only. So, okay, tell me if you have any questions. Okay, this is the last story for today anyway. So, any questions? So, the Morarji Desai, just give you the brief again, that he was from the Gujarat. Okay, he was born near Valsad, and then he was active during the freedom struggle. He joined Congress. He participated in the freedom struggle. Went to jail multiple times, and after independence, he became one of the important leaders of Congress. He became the Chief Minister of Bombay State, which was a unified state before Gujarat and Maharashtra were separated. He became a Finance Minister under Jawaharlal Nehru, also under Indira Gandhi. And he's the longest serving Finance Minister of India. He presented 10 budgets of the financial statements. And then in 1977, he became the first non-Congress Prime Minister of India. He's the oldest Prime Minister of India. He became Prime Minister at the age of 81. He got Bharat Ratna. He has also
When did he receive Bharat Ratna and Nishani Pakistan?
Oh, I don't recall the year. I think he visited Nishane Pakistan first in probably 1977 or 78. He received that. And in Bharat Ratna, he received in 1999 or 1998, somewhere like that. Okay.
Uncle, but he died on 1995.
Yes, I think he received Bharat Ratna after he died. I will confirm that part.
Oh, posthumously.
Posthumously, yes. Okay. I think he received Bharat Ratna before that, but after he was after he retired. So, he received Bharat Ratna in 90s only. Okay. Let me check that. So, Bharat Ratna. 1991. Okay.
Okay.
So he received Bharat Ratna in 1991 and he received Nishane Pakistan in 1990. Sorry, that was wrong. So, but yeah, he first received Nishane Pakistan, then received Bharat Ratna. That's right. Yeah.
So none of them was posthumously?
No. None of them were posthumously. One was in 1990, Nishane Pakistan, and Bharat Ratna was 1991. Okay. And he died in 1995. And he died at he lived for 99 years. If you see, 1896 to 1995. Yeah.
Almost a century.
Yeah, almost a century he lived. Okay. Yeah. So that's the story we have. All the stories we have. So now we know the name. Jatinder Mohan Sen Gupta we have. Then Rani Kaiden Liu, Radha Mohan Pal, and Moraji Desai.
Mr. Pal.
Yes. Now we'll do the fun quiz. Okay, quickly we'll do that. Now for the quiz, I will share a link. Okay, just okay in the Teams. Chat box, I will share a link.
Okay.
You can do that right now. You can do afterwards. But yeah, I'll showcase the this thing. You can do right now. That will also be good. Okay.
Uncle, can you put it in the chat box now?
Yes. I'll do it. I'm doing it. Okay. You can. This. I put that in okay. The chat. Okay, chat box. You can do it right now. So these are the questions. Okay, they both. Okay, you can do it right now, or you can do it even afterwards. That's fine.
Okay. I'm doing it right now.
Yeah. So everyone can do it. Yeah. Who is the only Indian to receive the highest civilian award from both India and Pakistan? Okay, that should be very simple.
That.
Yeah. Don't give the answers right now. Don't give the answers. Just okay. Use the answers there.
The fourth.
Okay.
Yeah, I think the fourth one I'm getting a bit of trouble with.
Yeah, don't worry. That's fine. Yeah, and with Mahatma Gandhi, Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan, Moraji Desai, Jawaharlal Nehru. Then what was the name of trial against Japanese guilty of war crimes in World War II?
That's easy.
Tokyo trial, Red Fort trial. Okay, everyone can do that. Okay. Others can unmute as well, but don't give up the answers.
There's a statue of Radha Binod Pal. This one I'm getting a little bit of trouble with.
Okay, no issues. This is okay. And Rani Gaidindu became the leader of Heraka movement at the age of 16. True or false? The statue of Radha Binod Pal in the front of Supreme Court of Pakistan. True or false? Jatinder Mohan Sen Gupta was given the
Uncle, I got test. Full marks.
Good. Well, Keshupriya. Rani Gaidindu was born in which present state of India? Assam, Manipur, Nagpur, and Mizoram. So others are doing. Samarth Pandit Aryan, you are also doing this? Yes, good.
No, sir, I'm done. I got two wrong.
No, sir, that's fine. Okay. This is
I got 60 out of 60.
Anvi is also there, right? Nice to see you, Anvi.
40 out of 60.
Oh, that's great, actually. You can do it the offline as well. Okay, you can go through this site and you upload this video. These are very simple one. If you don't know, that is fine. Okay, just reading about these people.
No,
very simple.
I'll copy the link so my dad also can do it.
Yes.
Will you send these links after every time we finish a class?
Yes. I'll do that. I'll put it in the WhatsApp. Okay, you can check that. Okay. So this will be fine.
Uncle, when will you keep the next Kahoot kind of quiz?
Okay, Kahoot type of quiz we'll probably do once in a month type. In February we had one. So probably in month of March, probably by the end of March we'll have one. Okay.
Uncle, my one was not successful.
Okay,
all was successfully.
Great, very good. That's fine. Yeah. And you anyway get the now answers, right? So and keep practicing. Okay. And Kahoot, yeah, next time we'll have, once we have Kahoot type of quiz, this will be helpful. So yes, great. So any other questions you have now? Anything no. you want to say? Okay, I hope you enjoyed the session. Yes or no?
Yes, uncle.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes. So thank you and keep reading. Okay, enjoy. Bye-bye.
Bye, uncle.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.